the day to everyone. My name is Rachita Mathur, currently working as a legal intern at LexClick. So today, I will be dealing with Law of Agency. So Law of Agency is defined under Chapter 10 of Indian Contract Act 1872. An agency means when one party delegates some authority to another party whereby the latter performs his action in more or less important fashion on behalf of the first party. So the relationship between them is known as an agency. Further, an agency can be expressed or implied. Further, there are mainly three main parties involved in an agency. The first one is the agent, the second one is the principal, and the third one is the third party. So, an agent means a person who is employed to do any act for another or to represent the another in dealing with the third person. Whereas the principal means the person from whom such act is done or is so represented. Therefore, the person who has delegated his authority will be the principal. For example, a businessman delegates B to buy some goods on his behalf. Here, A will be the principal and B will be the agent. And the person from whom the goods are being brought is the third person. Now, who can appoint an agent and who may be an agent? Here, the answer of both this question will be any person who has attained the age of majority and has a sound mind can appoint an agent. Further, in case of creation of agency, first one is the direct express appointment. Here, the standard form of creating an agency is by the direct appointment when a person in writing or speech appoints another person as his agent, an agency has been created between the two. In case of implication, when an agent is not directly appointed but his appointment can be inferred from the circumstances, an agency by implication will be created. Further, in case of necessity, one person can act on behalf of another to save that person from any loss or damages without expressly being appointed as an agent. This creates an agency out of necessity. Further, in case of agency by estoppel, here an agency may be created by an estoppel in a situation where one person behaves in such a manner in front of a third person as to make someone believe that he is an authorized agent on behalf of someone, an agency by estoppel is being created. Further, in case of rectification, when an act of a person who acted as another person or agent without his knowledge is later rectified by that person, that he creates an agency by rectification between the two persons. Further, there are total 9 types of agent. First is the special agent, second one is the general agent, third is the sub-agent, fourth is the co-agent, fifth is the factor, sixth is the broker, seventh is the auctioneer, and eighth is the commission agent, and the last is an agent who acts as a salesperson, broker, and guarantor for the principal. He guarantees the credit extended to the buyer. Further, in case of authority of an agent, it can be in the form of both express or implied. Further, the express and implied authority, both are given under Section 187 of Indian Contract Act. As in case of express authority, the authority is said to be expressed when it is given by words spoken or written. In case of implied authority, an authority is said to be implied when it is to be inferred from the facts and circumstances of the case. Further, there are mainly 4 types of implied authority, that is incidental authority, usual authority, customary, and last one is the circumstantial authority. So, there was one case of Chairman LIC versus Rajiv Kumar Bhaskar. In this case, it was being held that the employee was acting as the agent of the company, thereby making company responsible as the principal due to the fault of the agent. Further, agency between the husband and wife. Husband will be held responsible for the necessity to his wife when they are living apart due to the husband's fault. This results an agency of necessity where the wife can use her husband's credit for what is necessary for her to live. But in case where they are separated because of the wife's own fault for no just reason, the husband is not liable for the wife's necessity. Further, in case of sub-agent, a sub-agent is defined under Section 191 of Indian Contract Act 1872 as those person who are employed by or acting under the control of original agent in the business of the agency. Further, there was a maxim, delegatus non protest delegare. The meaning of this maxim is, an agent can't in ordinary circumstance delegate the duty that was delegated to him. The principle is based upon the idea, when a principal agent appoints an he does so by placing his confidence and trust in the agent and might not have similar trust in the work of another person. Further, in case of agency by rectification, here, if the act is being rectified, a relationship of the agency will come into commission, it will come into existence, and it will be as if he had previously authorized a person to do an act of his agent. Rectification may be expressed or implied both. Further, rectification is not allowed in two cases. First is when the person's knowledge of the facts of the case is defective. That is, when the person knows half thing that he is rectifying to. Second one is an act done on behalf of another person which would have the effect of injuring or harming the person or violating any of the rights if the act was done with his authority. Further, in five cases where termination of agency can be done is the first, when the agent's authority is revoked by the principal; second, when the agent renounced the business of the agency; third, when business of agency is completed; fourth, when either of the party die or become mentally disabled; fifth is when principal is adjudicated an insolvent. Further, revocation of agent's authority can be done in the four cases when it may be revoked at any time before the authority has been exercised. Second, if according to the terms of the contract between the two, the agency has to continue up to a certain time, any prior revocation by the principal shall be compensated for to the agent. Further, in case of termination, does not take effect before it has been communicated to the agent. Last one is the termination of the authority of an agent terminates the authority of all the sub-agents under him. Further, agent's duty to principal. He has to conduct the business of principal according to the directions of the principal. Second, an agent is bound to conduct the business as he is supposed to conduct with as much skill as a person on his position ordinary holds. An agent is supposed to show the relevant accounts of the principal as when the principal demands. An agent has a duty to communicate any difficulty whatsoever he may across while doing the principal's business. If any material facts has been concealed of the business is not carried out in a manner, then the principal has to direct. The principal can even repudiate the contract between them. If the agent carries out the business in the manner he wanted to perform it rather than on the directions of the principal in this case may claim from the agent any benefit he may have achieved from doing so. Now, the duties of principal duties to agent. Principal is bound to indemnify the agent against any lawful act done by him in the exercise of his authority as an agent. Agent is bound to indemnify the agent against any act which is done in a good faith, even if ended up while violating the rights of the third party. The principal is not liable for the agent if the act that has been delegated is criminal in nature. Further, the principal must make a compensation to his agent if he causes any injury to him because of his own competency or lack of skill. Further, the principal will be held liable for any fraud or misrepresentation that is being made by his agent during the course of his business, as if the fraud or the misrepresentation was being done by the principal himself. Further, there are five rights of the agent, that is the right of retainer, right of remuneration, right of lien on principal's property, fourth is right to be indemnified, and the last one is the right to compensation. Thank you.